Welcome to Abbott. Good morning on this beautiful day. If you'd like a hug, here you are.
Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing my great Redeemer's praise, the glories of my God and King, the triumphs of His grace. My gracious Master and my God, assist me to proclaim, to spread through all the earth abroad the honors of thy name. He speaks and listening to his voice, new life the dead receive, the mournful broken hearts rejoice, the humble
Welcome to Advent United Methodist Church in Eagan, Minnesota. I'm Pastor Eric Elkin, the lead pastor of this amazing congregation. Today is May 31st, a day we celebrate the miracle of Pentecost, a miracle where people of different regions, languages, colors, and socioeconomic levels all could understand each other. No image is harder to grasp this day than that one. We live in a region of the world with one common language, yet we have so little understanding of each other. Worse, every day it seems we are losing patience with each other. The lack of patience is drawing us farther apart. It's almost like we look for every possible way to be mad with someone not like us. Now, in the middle of this already volatile situation, we had the horrible and tragic death of George Floyd this week. His death while in police custody has set off protests and looting and other acts of violence. We cannot worship, praise, and give thanks to God and pretend like none of this ever happened, or that it has no influence over our faith life. At the same time, we need to remember that this congregation has people who are liberal and people who are conservative, people who are Republican and people who are Democrat. If we cannot find a way to speak of kindness, justice, and faith together, we have no hope of being a community. As we prepare our hearts and minds for worship, I would like to speak to all of you, regardless of your position or political opinion. The motto of the Minneapolis Police Department is to protect with courage, to serve with compassion. All of us, regardless of race, creed, or social position, need police officers willing to live by these standards so we can all be safe. Police officers need it for their safety as well. When a member of the department cannot abide by that standard, they may be in the wrong profession. In the land of the free, and we are granted freedom to protest. We are not afforded the privilege to loot and burn property regardless of how great the injustice. This is not justice, and this is not peace. Worse, it has never proved itself to be a reliable way to establish either peace or justice. It only breeds more chaos. This is an extremely heavy way to begin a worship service, but it is a reminder of why we as people of faith are so desperately needed at this time and place in the world. We need to be hope for a love-starved, impatient, and fearful world, trying to tear itself apart. Now, thank you for joining us, and I pray the Holy Spirit equips you in love this day, and let us begin service by praying for peace.
Let us pray for peace, for the healing of creation. May God's truth and justice mend every breach. May we learn to live as one. Let Let us pray for love, for the grace to offer mercy. May compassion guide our way in the world. May forgiveness heal division. May forgiveness heal us all. We pray for peace. We pray for understanding. Pray that hatred cease and God's reign is known on earth. God's reign is known on earth. Hear our prayer for peace. Hear our prayer for love. Hear our voices, Lord, this day. Lord, we pray for peace, for the healing of creation. May your truth and justice mend every breach. May we learn to live as one. You know our hearts. Selfish struggles, take away our pride and fill us all with you, and fill us all with you, fill us with your peace. Fill us with your love. Fill us all this day, O Lord, we is in heaven. May your reign of love be known in our lives. May your will be done among us. May we do your will.
Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing sweet praise. Oh, rushing wild Spirit of God, pour out your fire of love upon us. Unfurl your language on our lips. Unlock our minds to embrace all possibilities. Unleash our hearts so your justice flows freely. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing sweet praise.
Oh, rushing wild Spirit of God, pour out your fire of love upon us. May the breeze bring health and wholeness. May your breath fire up our resolve. May your Spirit storm the earth with mercy and grace. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing sweet praise.
O rushing wild Spirit of God, pour out the fire of love upon us. Set us free from self-doubt. Make us listeners as we seek awareness. Shake us awake when we forget our privilege. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing sweet praise.
Oh, rushing wild Spirit of God, pour out your fire of love upon us. Amen.
Amen.
The name that charms our fears, that bids our sorrows cease. 'Tis music in the sinner's ears, 'tis life and health and peace. In Christ your head you then shall bow, shall feel your sins forgiven, and 'tis the page your hand below.
A little bit ago, you asked me, why were we taking down the white flags just to put up red ones? What's up with that? Well, here's what's up with that. We are celebrating a day in the church called Pentecost. It's the 50th day after Easter, and Jesus had left the community, gone back to heaven, and the followers were wondering, what do we do now? What do we do? And so Jesus had told them, watch for it. I'm going to send you a gift. It's called the Holy Spirit. And that Holy Spirit is going to come like a wind. It's going to come like a rush of fire. And lo and behold, the people gathered were all speaking in their own language, yet they could understand each other. And the wind kept blowing, and there were flames of passion and excitement in the people. It was an amazing day. It's a day we celebrate the birthday of the church. Happy birthday, Advent! Happy birthday, church! Indeed, as we gather, that's what Pentecost is. It's a time where we all wear red. I hope you have your red on today. And it's a day when we celebrate the church becoming the church. I hear you're going to make us some Pentecost cupcakes. Is that right, Mr. Chris?
Oh, yeah.
Maybe now I should call you Chef Chris.
Want to bake some awesome Pentecost cupcakes with Chef Chris? Then tune into our Faith Builders lesson after worship. For now, we invite you to pass the peace within your hearts or within your homes.
We move now into our time of prayer. We begin with this prayer song.
Holy One, for all the ways you speak to us.
In rushing wind.
In dancing flames.
In words we understand.
And in all the transcends language.
We give you thanks.
Give us courage to speak your love.
To everyone we meet.
And everywhere we go. As we prepare our hearts and minds for this time of prayer.
Holy and gracious God, this day as we gather, there are prayers that are on our hearts. There are prayers that we will share with one another. There are prayers in which we don't even yet have words. But when those words come, we know that you will hear them. We pray this day for all those who are seeking work. We pray for friends and family undergoing cancer treatment. We pray for Leo as he recovers from surgery, and for Kenzie as she recovers as well. With hearts filled with gratitude, we lift up Glenn as he is recovering from COVID. Holy One, we give gratitude for the gift and blessing of each new day, filled with possibility and ours to create anew. Remind us that we are people of fire and spirit. We are called, we are compelled to move into the hard spaces and have the hard conversations about what it means to really be followers of the way of Jesus Christ. For it is in his name and by his grace that we join our voices in the prayer that he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As we hear the word of God today, it is the gift to us of the Holy Spirit that came after Jesus had left this earthly home. The Spirit is sometimes symbolized as flowing water, sometimes a dove, sometimes as wind and fire. And if you have made some streamers, now is the time to get ready with your tongues of fire and keep them going as you hear this reading.
Cuando escucharon este sonido, una multitud se congregó, se quedó rodeado y todos los escucharon hablar de los millones de niños. Se sostuvieron y asombraron y reconocieron si esas personas que hablan galileo acá de una de ellos, como lo digo, si estaba la señora de un
talk then different language where we they talk since we born.
I think this is what everyone is trying to say here. There were pious followers from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. When they heard the sound, a crowd gathered. They were mystified because everyone heard them speaking in their native languages. They were surprised and amazed, saying, "Look, aren't all these people who are speaking Galileans, each one of them? How then each of us can hear them speaking in our native languages? We hear them declaring the mighty works of God in our own languages." They were surprised and bewildered. Some asked each other, "What does this mean?" Others jeered at them, saying, "They are full of new wine." Peter stood with the other 11 apostles. He raised his voice and declared, "Judeans and everyone living in Jerusalem, know this. Listen carefully to my words. These people are not drunk, as you suspect. After all, it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. Rather, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy, your young will see visions, and your elders will dream dreams. Even upon my servants, men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. I will cause wonders to occur in the heavens above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and a cloud of smoke. The sun will be changed into darkness, and the moon will be changed into blood, before the great and spectacular day of the Lord comes, and everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved." The word of God for the people of God.
Blessed be God.
Long before the internet, television, or even theaters, even before words were written down on paper, our ancient ancestors used to gather around a campfire to tell stories. They would tell stories about the day's events and life. The stories they would tell were humorous, they were scary, they were weird, but the most important stories were the ones told about the family or the tribe. These family tales shaped their identity. It helped each generation understand the past, the present, and lead them out into the future. But it also passed down the core identity of the family from one generation to the next. We still practice this ancient art, although we don't think of it as an ancient art. This summer, families will gather around and share their stories, probably around a campfire. A collection of tales told over and over again to help each generation understand, and the present age not to forget. Not many people realize it, but we still share some of the most ancient stories known to humankind. Stories whose first telling happened around a campfire. The story of creation, the story of Noah and the flood, came from a time that predates ink, paper, and any kind of organized religion. Variations of these stories have been told around the globe among all sorts of ancient people. On this Pentecost Sunday, I'm thinking about one of these ancient stories, about the Tower of Babel. You can find it in the opening of the 11th chapter of Genesis. It comes after a time the flood waters have receded and a new generation of people has emerged. And this new generation of people all speak the same language. The people decide to build a tower and make a name for themselves so they will not be scattered or dispersed all over the earth. God sees the tower and, frankly, is threatened by the possibility. Threatened by the possibility of human intelligence. So God mixes up their language and spreads them out all over the globe anyway. The exact meaning of the story is difficult to say conclusively. However, we have tended to agree the story is about human aspiration and folly. Humanity tends to overreach itself. It takes a little too much pride in its wisdom and not enough respect for its limitations. This story of pride, meaning limitations, is being played out right in front of us as we speak. We never imagined something as tiny as a virus could do this level of damage to our modern world. For the longest time, historians and theologians thought the Tower of Babel an ancient fable. Like many ancient stories, they concluded, it uses imagery and meaning rather than accuracy and verification. Then archaeologists discovered the footprint of the Tower of Babel in modern-day Iraq. No matter what the ancient or modern interpretation, nor whether the tower existed or not, the story leaves the impression that confusion reigns when human beings cannot speak the same language. Though I'm still not sure why God would intervene to mess up everyone's communication, just seems weird. I find it funny that we human beings have outsmarted God. It took us some time to adapt, but eventually we did learn foreign dialects. In the wonder of human wisdom, we even created tutorial programs where people didn't even need to travel to foreign lands to learn a foreign dialect. Unfortunately, in the folly of human wisdom, different dialects or languages is not the issue keeping us from unity. Again, as modern culture puts folly on full display every day, we can all speak the same language and still not understand each other. Modern human culture has proved this about economics, politics, social order, and religion. The farther we move away from a common core, the more confusion, anger, and fear dominates our day. Where do we go from here? There are not many times when modern conditions helps us understand an ancient context, but I would argue today is one of them. The story of the Pentecost miracle comes at a time where the disciples and followers of Jesus are shocked into paralysis. They are sheltered in an upper room. They've been told to wait, but they're not really certain what they're waiting for. Then the sound of a fierce wind enters the room. Small flames appear above their heads. God is intervening into their lives. This time, unlike Babel, it is not to confuse language, but to enable it. God helps these strangers understand each other. The sound was not confined to the house or the room. It is loud enough to draw a crowd. These little flames of light are to become a big campfire. Words are shared, stories will be told, but in the moment, the crowd is confused. Most of us do not understand miracles, especially when they're happening. The crowd asks a question. It is a question I ask myself, especially when I think of Pentecost in the light of the Tower of Babel. What does this mean? Peter steps forward to answer. Peter, the one who never could find the right words during Jesus' ministry, nor the right words the night of his rest. Finally, here with the flame dancing above his head, he understands. All you need to know from his witness and his testimony is this one simple phrase. God says, "I will pour out my spirit upon all people." Every year, at the end of May, 50 days after Easter, we celebrate the Pentecost miracle. It is a story we tell to remember our identity. So if we ever find ourselves in a time of stress, where we're trapped by fear and worried about the future, we may take comfort in that God says, "I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh." We don't typically tell the story around a campfire, but a Christ candle. Campfires cover large areas, while the candle, the light of a candle, reminds us of the tongues of flame that danced over each disciple's head. This is a light of the Holy Spirit. Fire is a light which shines in the darkness. Here, the light shines in the darkness of confusion and uncertainty. The miracle is not that God has corrected a past condition, restored one common language. Instead, God has done something greater than language. God has breathed into humanity understanding. It shines so we might see the truth. Though Christ has died, he is not dead. And though he is not here, his spirit will give birth to visions, dreams, and life. We who remember this past event should allow it to frame our present and lead us into the future. God has and will continue to pour God's Spirit upon all flesh. Those who see this light will have visions of the future, and they will not be afraid to dream dreams. A flame is a chain reaction between three elements: heat, fuel, and oxygen. When heat reaches a flash point in connection to the fuel, it becomes a fire. For the fire to continue to burn, it needs oxygen. If you take any one of these links in the chain away, the fire will burn out. When you see the tongue of fire, whether in a picture or burning atop the Christ candle, consider the Holy Spirit the heat. You are the fuel. The flashpoint in the chain reaction is the moment when you understand the gift of faith, which is trust that God will sustain all people in life and in death with love. The oxygen is the community of people around you. Sharing this gift, whether through prayer, service, or words of hope, helps the flame burn bright. Those who receive the Holy Spirit are compelled by God to prophesy. Prophecy does not mean you go out and predict the future. It means to tell the truth. And the truth is, for thousands of years, God has been intervening in human history to sustain them in hope and love, and to weave into their hearts the promise of the resurrection. It is the light we continue to share for those living in darkness. The message of Pentecost is simple. Since God has poured out God's Holy Spirit upon you, you are to pour out that same Spirit on others, so we can all live in hope. May you find the hope of Christ this day and share it with a friend.
Lord.
darkest night.
One announcement to share with you today, and that is that beginning in the month of June, our new worship series is playfully titled Take a Hike. We will explore four Bible passages, all of which center on unique ways we walk in faith. Go ahead and create for yourself a walking stick if you'd like, fill up your water bottle, put on your backpack and hiking shoes, we'll walk together.
Yesterday, in the morning when I was recording my part for worship service, I added a message about what was going on in the city of Minneapolis and St. Paul over these last couple of days. Since that announcement, the situation has only gotten worse and shows no sign of improving anytime soon. It adds to the kind of tension of our culture right now with everything going on. We don't know what the future will bring. We can sit there as a congregation, and right now we feel solid and secure about where we are, but we don't know what the summer and the fall will bring. So as we take this time of offering, to collect our offering, I invite anyone who is watching this to maybe consider donating $10 or $15 to the church so we can continue our ministry, but also so that we can be a voice of hope and calm and peace and love in a very, very volatile time. Thank you for considering to support this ministry.
Let us join our voices together in the prayer of dedication. Holy One, we give thanks for your Spirit. Help us be like the early disciples, praying patiently as we wait for your guidance and power. Fill our hearts and minds with your gifts of faith, hope, and love. May our conversations with people of every language and culture around us be witness to your grace and mercy. We dedicate ourselves and our offerings to your good purposes in the world through our church's mission. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
From whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Alleluia, alleluia. Praise God, the source of all our gifts. Praise Jesus Christ, whose power uplifts. Praise the Spirit, Holy Spirit. Alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
In our moments of chaos,
God is with us.
In our moments of calm,
God is with us.
In our moments of life,
God is with us. Alleluia.
We go as a Pentecost people,
touched by fire,
stirred by wind,
to mend the world.
For that is the heart of the matter. Alleluia, amen.
Send forth your Spirit, O God. Send forth your Spirit, O God. And renew the earth. Send forth your Spirit, O God.
Send forth your Spirit, O God. Send forth your Spirit.
Spirit.